For the last couple of months, I guess Lux Prime just released a few new products. Was gonna hop onto the lip stain. It is called Lux Prime Ultra Light Lip Stain, and I've got 5 colors. These products, they leave stains and they're quite powerful, and that is why I couldn't just swatch all of them in 1 hour. I had to give it some time for the stain to actually fade away completely. So I just filmed 1 lip stain per day. So I'm gonna start with the color Rose Sand because it looks the most orangey and calm one. But once you swatch it, it actually looks a little bit less brownish than what I thought it would be. And also it has more red in it as well. It looks like that even more after I applied it on my lips. Now for the shade Flamingo, this one has more brown to it. So it does look a little bit calmer than the Rose Sand one. It is kind of like a mauvey pink with a little bit of red undertone as well. And after you apply it, this one looks the most muted out of all of the colors. But after you let it set, it does look a little bit more red as well, just like the other ones. Now for the color Apricot, it looks like the color Flamingo, but with a little bit more red in it. But still, it looks so similar to the Flamingo one, but I feel like the Flamingo one has a little bit more brown in it and less red. The color Glastonbury, it is the deepest out of all of them. In my opinion, it is still not as deep as I want it to be after you applied it. It is just red, just simply red. And then for the last color, this Amber, I feel like this is the most distinctive. The one that stands out the most, so it is a neonish candy color and it's just pure orange. I would say burnt orange actually. It is more of a red undertone orange. I did not have the energy to pose like I usually do because I was just so let down by the color. It's just that I really love muted brownish colors and they all look pretty much the same to me. There's not one that is muted enough for me to wear without any makeup base. All of them except for the Amber one, of course, that's like a straight up neonish candy color. They've all got this red stain to it, so maybe that's why all of them pretty much just looked red and not a muted kind. I think all of my tints or stains, they all have these red stains to them, but like when you let it set, at least it won't turn red, if that makes sense. It only turns red after you try to smear it off with some tissue or something like that, or after you ate, that's when the red shows. But with this one, even if you just let it set, it will turn kind of red. So now for the formula, it is very similar to the Amina Glossy Stain. I think the Lux Prime one is just a teensy tiny bit more pigmented, and also the stain that it leaves, it is a little bit more even than the Amina one. And these lip stains are also not drying, but they also did not hydrate or moisturize my lips. So they were, like formula wise, it is a good one. So that is why I feel like all of us lip tints or lip stains lovers were like on our knees, please release some brownish nude colors. Because I've watched a review, a lip tint review from one of my favorite beauty vloggers, and she showed us these brownish orangey muted colors in a lip tint form, and I was like, okay, it is not impossible. If you have the same taste as me and you want the most muted color out of the bunch, I would definitely recommend the Flamingo one. And for the eyeliner, they've got the Lux Prime Ultra Stay eyeliner. They've got 2 colors. Now the tip of the eyeliner, it is a little bit thicker than what I would prefer, so it is thicker than the Something Black as Black Forever Stay eyeliner, but it is still something that I can handle, so it is not too thick to the point where I can't even draw a line. Absolutely not. I can still get into my inner corners with this. Now for the colors, they've got Midnight, and I feel like it is a quite pitch black color, so it is very similar to the Something one, which I think is a almost true black color. It is quite rich. And the color Espresso is just a tiny bit more glowy than the Midnight one. I just feel like if it's not completely matte, you can't really see the true color. It kind of gives the illusion as if the colors are a little bit grayish, even though they're actually not. But yeah, for the Espresso color, it's kind of like a contour color. And I wish that I would release one that is a little bit lighter than this, but not too as red as the BLP one. So still a contour color, but a little bit lighter. And when you apply both of them on your eyelids, they both kind of look the same, but I feel like the Espresso one looks more natural because it is like a contour color, so it looks like it is meant to be on your eyes. So like it's a part of your eyes, whereas the black one, it makes your eyes look more pop. I actually like both of them, but I think because the espresso one is a little bit more glowy, a little bit more glossy, and I prefer matter ones, I think I like the color midnight more. It does stay like the something one. It is not the type of eyeliner that will kind of crumble and fall after a few hours, nope. But it does kind of change color a little bit.
Especially if you cry.
Once I cried because I thought about something that I shouldn't be thinking of, and it still held up pretty well. But you can see the color changing just a teensy tiny bit into a grayish color. And then the next day, I watched like the last scene from Into the Wild. You cannot not cry watching that movie if you've got a son. And yeah, I cried like a baby. And I also just went out for a couple of hours before that, so I did have a long day. It did get through some, just a lot of obstacles, not to mention me rubbing my eyes over and over again. So yeah, it did fade quite a lot. I definitely had to reapply after that, but it is definitely tear-proof, but not rubbing your eyes proof. It is not Into the Wild proof. But is it a good eyeliner? Yes, it is really similar to the Something one in terms of formula, and I really love the Something one. I just hope that they would release ones that are more matte. Now for the blushes, it is called Luxe Prime Flushy Cheek Blush. They've got three colors, and it is a powder pressed blush. For the first color, I'm gonna try the Blueberry Muffin one. It's kind of like this a calm, muted berry color in the pan, but once you apply it, it still looks muted, but it gives you this fresh feel to it, and all of the color do the same thing. So they're not too muted that it looks almost like a bronzer. Nope, they make your face, all of them make your face look like energized by this blush, and just looks more youthful. And this one is the most pigmented out of the bunch. So you need to be just a teensy tiny bit careful with this one, even though it is so easy to blend out or to diffuse. If you want to, you just need to take your big powder blush and everything will be fine. And for the second one, I'm gonna try the Strawberry Pie. It is a pink, muted pink color as well in the pan. Once you apply it on the cheeks, of course, it is a little bit of a lighter pink, and it looked a little bit cool on my warm undertone kulit sawo matang skin. But after I blended it out, it did look kind of cute actually. It looks like I was blushing from within. But it's definitely my least favorite color. My favorite color is, of course, the Peach Cobbler. It is a warmer version of the Strawberry Pie because there's a little bit of orange in it, and that's why it is called peach. And this is also the kind of a color that makes your face look fresh, so not too muted. But yeah, this is definitely my favorite color. This goes with so many of my lipsticks or eyeshadows, and I feel this is very pamula friendly, beginner friendly, because it is not too pigmented on, I mean, for the first swipe, and it is a slow builder, so you can just leave it a little bit less pigmented, or you can just build up the pigmentation without dipping in like two or three times. Like one time is enough. It is foolproof in my opinion, so that is why I said it is beginner friendly. And it also lasts up so long on my face, especially for a powder blush. Usually they fade quicker than liquid blushes. And I also really love the texture because it doesn't add any visible texture on my cheeks. It only adds color, only adds pigmentation. I'm just going to compare it to the Ines one. I really love that blush, but it does add a little bit kind of a heavy texture to it, and also a little bit of shimmer. And also the Amina one, it has this kind of chalky texture to it, and this one does not. It just adds color. So I really love this blush. It's definitely one of the best, not only in terms of formula but also colors. I just wish that they would release a few more shades that a little bit deeper than this one, the Blueberry Muffin one, in a peachy tone. So like a deeper version of the Peach Cobbler, I mean. Now for the bronzers, they've only got two colors, so Chocolate Pretzel and Peanut Butter Cookie. So first I'm gonna trying out the color Peanut Butter Cookie, and it is way too light, I guess, for me, but also not that, it is also way too grayish for my skin, and that is why I was like, oh no, I just want to take this off immediately. I feel like this is more of a contour color, not a warm it up bronzer. It is supposed to look a little bit more reddish or yellowish or orangish than this one. This is just straight up contour for lighter skin tones. But I really love the Chocolate Pretzel one, so this is deeper and also a lot warmer than the other one. It looks pretty on my skin. It does look sun-kissed on my skin, but also it is deep enough to be a contour shade as well on my skin tone. So it is safe to say that for me, the chocolate pretzel one is the only color that I can use. The other one is way too grayish. And it might look a little bit too red on screen, on camera, but actually it is not. And it's even not as red as my very favorite bronzer from Sada. I always like that one because I said it is not too red. This is even less redder than that one. And it is also slightly deeper than the Sada one. So it's like a bronzer slash contour color. Every time after I use it, I feel like my face is already contoured as well without that harsh look feel. That's why I really, really love this color. But the only thing that I don't like is the wear of it. I feel like it fades so fast. I feel like after a few hours, I can't really see the product anymore. So I would say this is a good bronzer. I really enjoyed using this, but I wouldn't say this is one of the best simply because it doesn't wear out that well. But this is definitely going to be in one of my most used products. This and the blush will hit the pan real fast. I can definitely tell you that. Yeah, there are no horrible products for the new launches here. As per usual, like LuxCrème, they don't release horrible products. Even their worst products in my best and worst one, it was still better than a bunch of other products that I can name. But yeah, for LuxCrème, I feel like our standards are very high. So that's why I wasn't saying like, the eyeliner is so amazing. No, it is a good one, but it could be better. It could be more matte. So just to recap, my favorite product is the blush. And then comes the bronzer, and then the eyeliner, and the least favorite one is the lip stain, simply because I just cannot stand the color, not the formula. That was it, you guys. Bye.